chapter 17 and verse 18. Here's Jesus talking. He says, in the same way that you, talking to the Father, gave me a mission, he says, in this world, I, the Son, I give them a mission in the world. Who's them? That's us. In the same way that God the Father gave Jesus a mission in the world, he says, I now give them a mission. I give them, I have a purpose for them to fulfill. God has given each and every one of us a unique mission that only you can accomplish. You were made unique. You were made like none other. God knew you before he even formed you in the womb. And not only did he know you, but he said, I have a purpose for you to fulfill in this life. You are a puzzle piece that has to accomplish what you were born and created for to accomplish, or the world gets cheated because of it. The world is far the less for it if you don't do what it is that God has called you to do. So let's go one more place. Proverbs 29:18. It says, where there is no vision, the people perish. Hey, this is true in any aspect of your life. If a business doesn't have a vision, the business falls apart. If a family or a marriage doesn't have a vision, the marriage and the family begins to fall apart. If you do not have a vision, well then now you are just drifting through life with no clear purpose, no defined purpose of what it is that you're supposed to accomplish with your life. And God didn't put you here on this planet just to drift through life. But he says that I have a mission for you to do. Grab a hold of the vision. Energize it, expand it, grab hold with both hands, don't let go, because I'm going to take you places that you never dreamed possible, because you have a mission. Yeah, it doesn't matter what age you are. I don't care if you're young. I don't care if you consider yourself old. I don't care if you feel like you don't have very many talents. I want to tell you that if your heart is beating, feel that. You feel that beat? That means you have a purpose. Your heart is beating. You have a purpose that God wants to use you for, to accomplish his will through your life, through into others. Oh, yes, this is an exciting. So what does all this mean? It means that God, if I've been doing my plan long enough. Oh, when we want to grab a hold of what God's mission is for us, we have to first say, I've done it my way long enough. It's time that I turn over the reins. And since you created me, you designed me, you shaped me, that I want to start doing things your way now. And hey, I want to tell you what, that's success right there. That, you know, that's the very first step when we decide that we want to fulfill this purpose in our life of accomplishing the mission that God has designed us for. That's the very first thing, is deciding that I'm not going to do things my way anymore. I had a lady, a good friend of mine, that she always would come to me and she'd say, hey, I want to know what I'm supposed to do with my life. I don't know what God's plan is for me. And I used to always tell her the same thing. I'd say, sister, spend time in God's word every day. Spend time in prayer every day. Just strengthen that relationship between you and him. I said, and when God has something for you, he will open the door, and then you just got to walk through it. And you will recognize his voice, whatever that is. You just make yourself available. And I remember several years had passed, and she came to me again, and she said, hey, I really just want to know what God's, you know, will is for me in my life. What am I supposed to be doing for him? And I said, you know, in the last couple of years, I have seen you grow your ministry so much. And she said, what do you mean? What ministry? I was like, well, you take, I don't know how many people that can't get out of their house. You go grocery shopping for them. You take them places. You pick them up and you take them for ice cream. You take them to different other places. You take them to get something to eat. You buy their groceries. You go to their house and you just hang out and you spend time with them. Like, you have no idea the impact that you are having, not only in our church, but in the community in general. Like, it's amazing what God is doing with you in your life. And she had never really realized that all those little things had added up to this huge ministry that she was doing. It was every day of the week that she was doing something for someone that could not do for themselves. And I want to tell you something, brothers and sisters. There is no higher calling than for you to give to someone that cannot repay you. That you are able to step out and fill a void, meet a need that nobody else can do. And if you think that that is insignificant, I'm sorry, but you have to realize that when you're helping others, you are serving the Lord and a high calling. And so that's the very first thing, is to just say, I don't want to do this thing my own way anymore. Lord, use me. How is it that you can use me? You know, here in America, we have the good life, don't we? Regardless of where you're at financially or socially, I could probably look around. I just about guarantee that I could look around and not have to look very hard to find someone in worse shape than what you're in. And hey, I get kind of caught in this trap sometimes of wanting to, you know, hey, you know, I don't really have the nicest vehicle compared to so-and-so. Or, wow, isn't their house really nice? Or, must be nice to be able to put money up and, you know, not have to worry about bills all the time. Those kinds of things begin to creep in. And God's like, what are you talking about? Or maybe you say, hey, I got it pretty good. I don't really compare myself to who has whatever, because what I have, I think, is pretty nice and I'm pretty content with what I have. You know what? Either way, we are wrong. Either way. Why? Because we're looking at good life by haves and have nots. The have and the have nots is not how we compare what God wants for us. We call it the good life. We either want it or we have it. God is saying, I'm not worried about you having the good life. I'm trying to offer you a better life. I'm trying to offer you something that this world cannot offer you. You see, living the good life is about shallow, superficial, materialistic things that are just going to go away. They're just going to be gone one day. It's not going to carry over to eternity. Remember, our purpose here on earth is a preparation for eternity, for the trillions and trillions of years that we're going to be living with our Heavenly Father, that none of that we have here is going to carry over to there. And I want to go a little bit farther. If it did carry over, it would be nothing in comparison. I don't care how much money you have. I don't think that you're driving on a street of gold. Hallelujah. That day is coming that the materials of this world is stuff that it's just pavement. We're going to walk on it. It's just a pathway. The things that we, you know, think are so, so important, and, you know, they glitter and they shine and, you know, everybody else has it, so I want it too. All those things are going to be gone, and we're going to walk on it. Yeah, hallelujah. So, you know, when we're looking at have and have nots, we're just looking at a very shallow, superficial life that is not what God has designed us for. He designed us that we would have a better life. Jesus said in Matthew 11 and 28 through 30, he says, are you tired, worn out, burned out on religion? Come to me for real rest, and you'll recover your life, and you'll learn to live freely and lightly. It makes no difference who you are or where you're from. If you want God and you're ready to do as he says, the door is open. Oh, what a powerful, powerful scripture that is. He said, I'm not offering you religion. I'm offering you life. I want to give you life. I want you to have life and have it more abundantly. I'm not concerned about whether or not you call yourself Baptist or Catholic or Lutheran or anything else. I don't care what it is that you call yourself. Maybe you don't call yourself anything. Maybe you don't know. Maybe you're not a religious person at all. Maybe you don't know Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior. He's like, I want to offer you a better life regardless of what you call or do not call yourself. This is what I'm trying to get through. God made us for a mission, that we have a mission, and that what we're going to be doing here on earth is what we're going to be doing for all of eternity. Choose the good life, the better life. Choose the life that He is offering to us. That's what we're going to be doing forever. He says, what matters is that you do have a relationship with God who loves you and sent His Son to die for you on the cross. Doesn't matter what your background is. Doesn't matter where you came from. It doesn't matter what you've done with your life or done in your life. It doesn't matter what other people think of you. Doesn't even matter what it is that you think of yourself. It only matters what He thinks of you. And He thinks of you so much that He died on the cross, that He left the beauties of heaven. He came to earth. He was born as a man. He went through this life with suffering and persecution and ridicule. He sacrificed Himself and died on a cross and didn't stay there, but rose up 3 days later and is now sitting at the right hand of the Father and has prepared a place just for you. Oh, it's powerful. Oh, my goodness. He loves you that much. He loves you that much. He loved me that much. And I'm so thankful that He did. I wasn't always so lovable. And it didn't matter to Him. He's like, I still want you. He says, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anybody would hear my voice, open the door and I will come in and I will dine with you and you with me. What a better way. What a better life. That when we fully give our life and submit our life to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, maybe you've asked the Lord to forgive you of your sins, but maybe Savior is where we stopped. Maybe we haven't quite given up the Lord part and said, Lord, You're my master. I'm going to follow You. And whatever it is that You do, I'm going to follow You. And so regardless of where you're at in your spiritual walk, I want to challenge you. I want to encourage you to say today, this day, right now, call it out. This day, right now, I'm going to stop doing things my way. And I want to do things Your way, Lord. Because I know that You have a mission for me, and I know that You have a purpose for me, and I want to fulfill the purposes that You've designed me for. Because not only will I have a better life, but people around me will have a better life, and my cup will overflow to the point that they will be able to rise up as well. It's all about where it is that we are headed right now. It doesn't matter how long we've been a Christian. It doesn't matter how long we've been a follower of Christ. It doesn't matter how much time we've spent in the Word. Sometimes we still have doubts, and I guarantee you, we don't have all the answers. And it doesn't matter how many years I've studied God's Word, I don't have the answers. If I had it all figured out, well, then I'd be God. Well, I'm not. I'm not even close. And, you know, I trust Him because everything I've ever read, and everything that's ever happened to me in my life, His Word has backed it up, and He has proven Himself true over and over and over again, and He has never, ever let me down. Even though I have let Him down more times than I can count, He has never let me down. He is so faithful, and He wants a relationship with you, and He wants to offer you a better life than what it is that you have right now, a more fulfilling life. And it begins with accomplishing those purposes that He put us here for, to know Him, to love one another, to grow spiritually, to use our shape to serve Him by serving others, and to fulfill the mission by first saying, it's not about me, it's about You. What can I do for You today? My friends, I just want to close in a prayer for our lesson here. I want to pray for you. I'll pray for me. Let's bow our heads. Lord, as we close, I just want to say that I know that I have, and I'm sure that other people that are watching and listening have been living a good life, not realizing that there's a far better life, a life of purpose. Forgive us, Lord, for the shallow living. Forgive us for thinking that life's only about collecting possessions or having pleasure or achieving popularity. But Lord, I pray that today that many of us, including me right now, will step across the line to a better life, the life of purpose and of power and of peace. Lord, we just want to say yes to you. We just want to say yes to you right now. Lord, that we want to fulfill the purposes that you have made us for. That starting today, Lord, that we'll get to know you and to love you and to trust you. Lord, that we want our life to bring you pleasure and we want to become a part of your family. Help us to grow up spiritually. Help us to live like you have called us to live. Thank you, Jesus, for dying for me. And Lord, in the weeks ahead, help us to just allow these lessons to just become more and more ingrained. Lord, if we have to go back and listen to them again, if we have to get back out that word and study the same ones over again, Lord, allow these lessons become more and more ingrained because we, your children, want to accomplish the purposes that you have designed for us, how you've called us. We want to bring you pleasure. We want to bring you joy. We want to bring joy to those that are around us. Lord, as we do every single week, Lord, we just want to just pray for those that are sick. Lord, the ones that don't know you as their Lord and Savior, Father God, by your Holy Spirit, that you would just begin to reveal your love to them. Lord, touch the sick. You said in your word that you bore those stripes for our sickness and for our suffering, that you suffered for us. I can't thank you enough for what it is that you've done. Lord, help us with our daily lives. Help us to just continue to grow in you. And we're going to give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. My friends, if you don't have a church home, we invite you to come and join us at Cordon New Hope. You can find us at cordonnewhope.com. Come and be a part of us. Come and enjoy the services. Sundays at 9 a.m. and 10:45 a.m. Wednesday night prayer meeting. Powerful prayer meetings. Wednesday nights at 6:30. If you have a church home, I want you to go to your church home. I want you to get planted. I want you to grow deep roots. I want you to get involved. I want you to take what you learn and I want you to share it with others. Find yourself a Bible-believing church if you don't live around the Cordon area or, you know, give me a holler. I know people all over the country. Give me a holler. Give me a shout out. I will help you. I will help you in any way I can. Jesus loves you. Have a great day today and a better one tomorrow. I love you, and I'll see you next week.